Hi, I'm Betsy. I'm a speech-language pathologist and master clinician with PN Medical. I'm excited to be here with you as you begin your journey with respiratory muscle training today. Let's get started. If you have not unboxed your breather yet, go ahead and do that with me now. It should be easy to open. You'll notice the breather all put together with the standard mouthpiece. It's ready to go. There's also this smaller adapter. This is used in place of the standard mouthpiece in some cases, such as if you're using the breather in conjunction with another device, or it can be used with a filter that will filter both inspiratory and expiratory airflow to help protect the user, as well as others in close contact during use. And in some cases, such as with children, users may find the adapter a better fit to use as a mouthpiece. These circumstances are certainly less common, but we wanted to make sure this adapter was immediately available to any who would need it. All right, let's take a closer look at the breather. You can separate the mouthpiece from the white body of the device, which you would do if you needed to clean it or if you wanted to use the adapter we just spoke of. You'll also notice the numbered dials on the sides of the breather. One is labeled inhale and the other exhale. These are the dials that set the levels of resistance for inhale and exhale. They can be adjusted independently of one another. Number one is the lowest setting for both, and each increase in number is an increase in resistance. So let's see the breather in action. Watch me show Wendy how to use the breather now. Today we're going to get started with respiratory muscle training. It's very similar to strength training you may have done at the gym. For example, if I move my arm like this, I'm using these muscles, exercising them. If I add weight and I do that same exercise, those muscles have to work even harder. This is an example of resistance exercise. The breather device allows us a complete resistance exercise for the muscles of respiration. You'll notice that there's numbers on the sides of the breather. These dials control the level of resistance you will breathe in and out against. Listen for the wind sound as I breathe in and out through the breather against resistance. Now it's time to try your breather. You'll see there are places to put your fingers so that you can hold your breather without impeding the airflow. I'm going to guide Wendy in her first try, and I invite you to try right along with her.
Place the mouthpiece in your mouth. Try not to clench it with your teeth. I don't want you to tense up your jaw. Now breathe in through the mouthpiece, hold, and breathe out through the mouthpiece. Did you hear the wind sound?
Yes.
Great. That wind sound means you're working those muscles of respiration at a therapeutic level. Let's try again. See if you can do 5 breaths in a row. Good. That's great. Keep going. Beautiful. One more. How did that feel?
Good.
Do you feel out of breath?
No.
Good. If you ever do feel out of breath during respiratory muscle training, I want you to stop and take a break.
Now that you've got a feel for the breather, let's talk about a training plan. A general training protocol begins with 10 reps. Each rep is a breath, including an inhale and an exhale. Then take a 1 to 2 minute break, followed by 10 more reps. These 2 sets of 10 reps is considered a session. For this general training plan, you will do 2 sessions a day. I recommend 1 session anytime in the AM hours of the day, and a second session anytime in the PM hours. You'll do this 6 days a week. After about a week, you'll begin to notice a difference in the ease of your breathing during respiratory muscle training. It may be time to try increasing the resistance. But how will you know what is the correct level resistance for you? And when to try changing these levels of resistance? These are great questions. During respiratory muscle training, we want to be sure our effort is in the zone. If we go through the motions of respiratory muscle training without sufficient effort, down at the 0 to 4 end of the scale, we'll gain little benefit. You'll know you're at this end of the scale if you can carry on a conversation with little to no breathlessness. But it's also important not to overdo it. You know you're in the 8 to 10 range of this scale when your breathing has gotten so heavy that you can only say a short word or you can't speak at all because you're gasping for air. It may seem like the harder we push, the more benefit we will gain, but this is just not the case. So we're asking you to listen to your body, gauge your effort, and stay in the zone, the 5 to 7 number range of this scale. This is the exercise range, what we're calling in the zone for respiratory muscle training. Level 5, you can continue a conversation, but you're breathing heavy. At level 6, you can still speak, but you're limited to 1 to 2 sentences with heavy breathing. At level 7, your breathing has increased to the point that you are now speaking in broken sentences. You may experience times when you need to decrease resistance to continue your respiratory muscle training program. Like when you have bad days with your chronic condition, or a temporary illness hits, or a time away from respiratory muscle training for any reason. Scaling back in resistance levels or taking more breaks during these times is not a setback. It is a step forward in the true story of life, which naturally has ups and downs. Resistances will increase as you strengthen and decrease sometimes when your body needs to ease up. It's a win if you can make the adjustments and keep your effort during respiratory muscle training in the zone so you can experience the slow and steady progress that will allow you to enjoy the benefits in various areas of your life. As you continue on your respiratory muscle training journey, it's a good practice to begin each session with this pre-session checklist. To ensure your mind and body are ready for respiratory muscle training. How are you feeling today? Make sure you're positioned with a straight back. Check that the dials are on the correct setting. Bring the mouthpiece to your mouth and focus on breathing from your diaphragm and keeping your effort in the zone. I hope you have found this video helpful. Please continue to use PN Medical as a resource as you move forward. Take advantage of our videos, printable resources, or even contact us with questions.